the charge in his car.
I was just headed someplace else to do a new movie, and then all of a sudden I heard an emergency call. We have to come here and help celebrate. What are we celebrating?
The sesquicentennial of the Relief Society.
How do you spell Relief Society? R-O-L-A-I-D-F, right? Is that the way we spell it? Is there any other way to spell Relief Society than R-O-L-A-I-D-S? Well, that's okay, because I'm here and I've got a great thing. Can I do a few jokes for you or something?
Sure.
Great, as long as there's no Mormons here. I got a whole thing. Never mind, forget it. It's not going to work with this crowd, I can already see. They're not drinking. Okay, well, what do you want me to do? Great! Are you in charge of this?
I don't think so.
Okay, don't trip on my car. They need this on safe. I'll get this on safe.
Okay,
well, what I've been asked to do, emergency, no? Don't leave. What I've been asked to do is take you on a kind of a time travel of our war. So what I would thought we would do is begin with the present, as bad as that may be. Let's just take a look at what your war is like now. Okay?
Brothers and sisters, welcome to Ward Council meeting. Let's get right down to business. I have several items of business to take care of tonight, but first I'd like to give you time to voice your concern. Let's start right here on the right.
Bishop, I am really having problems in scheduling the building. If we do not solve these problems, we are going to have to cancel the roundup. First of all, I've got the state calling me. They want to schedule some kind of fireside that night. And then there's the basketball thing. Kieran Christensen and all these guys in the state have decided this regional basketball is so great that they want to have a quarter. And then we've got CB3 scheduling weddings clear in the next year, but the young women want the building every single night. Well, we have a lot of activities going on. Besides, there's that room over by the kitchen. You can use that. Oh, wait a minute. June 5th. Sorry. Yeah, you can. Oh, I know. You can use the janitor's closet. Oh, wait a minute. Looking at, no, June 5th. We're doing a service project in there. Can't use the janitor's closet.
Vern, write that down. Fraser, we're just going to work on this in a minute.
You know, Bishop, we're having a tough time getting the high priest up to the temple. We try to set something up for the first Saturday morning of every month. And what we do is we meet out here in the parking lot at 5:30 a.m. and we just carpool over the temple.
Is that going to be a problem?
Wait a minute. Parking lot? We need the parking lot! All the time!
I can see the problem here, Brother Bevan. We've got to find a solution. Vern, make a note of that.
This is a problem, but with this awful flu going around, we could really have our hands full. Why, just yesterday, I took 12 meals in all by myself. We're having quite a time trying to get well-balanced meals to all of these families. If things don't improve, we're going to have to come here and use the cooking facilities in the kitchen.
Oh, no, you can't use the kitchen. We need that, too.
Make a note of that. I really am concerned with all the problems you have, but you know, we've got to focus our energies because our sacrament to keep meeting attendance is way down, and you know our budget depends on our attendance and sacrament meeting. So we got to work on that. Also, our reverence. What are we ever going to do about our reverence?
Hold it. This is downright depressing. Can you close these curtains? I'm tired of hearing these guys chat. You guys should be ashamed of yourself. That's what really happens. We came here to be entertained, right? We want to be cheered up. We don't want to be bummed out by these people. We're going to solve these problems right now, then we'll go on to a different era, okay? So just sit tight with me and let me work on this. You guys.
No, I'm not. minutes.
All those who can nominate him to
that man makes his own bow ties and reupholsters his own furniture, if anyone deserves to be in the police society, that man should be there. There's someone that can accept that award for you. Do we have any other nominees to go in? I mean, I really racked my brain trying to find a man qualified going to the police side. This is all I could come up with. Any of you wives want to nominate your husbands? Oh, there is one more person. Bill Bergen, come on down. Bill. Where's Bill? Come on. Where'd he go? There he is. Boy, you're turning to shade too. Look at you. Colorful. Let me tell you, Bill Bergen was a slave for quite a while, weren't you? And he was the man behind the scenes. Now, I noticed that your wife broke her arm hauling lumber around. So I gotta assume you're healthy because you've been knitting, right? Okay, and because of that, you are in the Relief Society. Said he knows. You don't want to be that in name only. So you are now the cleanup committee, okay? Now let's see how we're doing in the past. We're talking a reedy time. Leave it ready.
Pleased to be here, aren't we, brother?
Hello, Carol. I'm Lloyd Allen Slate, and this is my wife, Gaeta. We're looking for a cave in your area and thought we would visit the ward for a few weeks.
Thank you. Communication
Protection in a marriage is absolutely vital, brethren. Couples need to discuss their problems with each other. Hear me? Brethren, talk to your wives. Be kind to your wives. Listen to their needs. But sisters, if that fails, just use this.
Yeah.
Whoa! Run for the border!
Let me tell you,
morning. Be sure to bang some bodies around out there. By the way, Scott, you should look in trim these days.
Well, thank you! I think it's my new diet. I only eat things that start with the letter A. I read about it while I was standing in line over at Safeway. You know, I think my new outfit helps too. I got it on sale at Nordstrom's. Well, thank you. That's the new Black & Decker cut.
And I always draw the crowd.
Future. That's our show for tonight, and we'll see you later.